in today's video, we are going to be making a homemade thermometer out of a plastic bottle. So the ingredients are rubbing alcohol, tap water, some clay, a straw, food coloring, cold tap water and hot tap water, and a beaker so we can easily transfer our liquids into the plastic bottle. So let's begin. So now we are going to be making the solution. We're going to be adding 250 ml of tap water and 250 ml of rubbing alcohol. Now we're going to be adding 250 ml of rubbing alcohol. We're going to be adding 2 drops of food coloring. You can also use gel food coloring. So let's start. We're gonna add just a bit more food coloring to make it a bit brighter. In the straw. Ooh, it's so cool. It's turning so nice. Now let me just close this up and we can work on the straw. So we made a hole in the bottle.
mark where the water goes. Let's see. Just wait. It's still rising, so I can't mark it up. Alright, I can't mark it. Because it's still rising. Whoa, guys, it's almost to the tippy top. It's like filling the brim. Whoa. Whoa. Whoa, whoa. Oh, it exploded. Oh. Exploded. Guys, this is the mark of the temperature when it was still normal, and this is the temperature of, I mean, when it was still in cold water, and you clearly see here that this is the mark when it's in hot water.
So thank you guys for watching this video, and I will give my observation later on.
My conclusion. In this experiment, the water reacted to the hot and cold temperature. The water expands or increases when I put it in hot water. And the water contracts or decreased when I put it in the cold water. And when it was in room temp, it was just in the middle of the straw. It shows that as the water heats up, the space between the water molecules expands. So, hot water is less dense than cold water. As the water heats up, the less dense liquid rises to the surface of the container. The opposite is true. As the water cools down, the space between the molecules contracts. The liquid becomes more dense and the liquid sinks. Hope you guys like it. Bye!